Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be doing a celebrity tarot reading, and this is the first episode. And I specifically plan to do a celebrity reading for Britney Spears because I love her so much. But if you have any suggestion in mind, may it be a Filipino celebrity, but you know guys that I'm a Filipino. And if any suggestions are very welcome, or any celebrity from the US or Hollywood or Korean star, K-pop, Chinese superstars that you idolize, you can comment down below. And any British, European superstars, kahit ano pa yan. But today, this reading is for Britney Spears. So let me just first get her current state of mind. This is the kind of deck that I kind of hate. This is really, really hard to shuffle. I struggle a lot in shuffling Spirit Song for some reason. But we're gonna get her current state of mind. This is the shadow. Five of Shells. Okay. Eight of Acorns. Okay. Just put this aside. The shadow is the devil in the traditional tarot. But using the Spirit Song tarot, it makes the tarot reading pretty much like a positive positive reading. Redundant. I'm sorry. The shadow is typically it's like addictions or something that holding you back, or vices or betrayal or traitor, something like that. But when it comes to using Spirit Song tarot, Pauline Cassidy put the self-empowerment and ambition. And let's take a look at the Five of Shells. There's hope and a readjustment. I think with these two cards in her current state of mind, plus the other two here, the King of Shells and the Eight of Acorns, I think the shadow represents her ambitions in being very adventurous. And also, she's been doing her self-development. I mean, she's working out because her boyfriend is really a great physical trainer, and even though she's not touring anymore, she still works out, and that's a really good thing. She still dance, and that means that she still wants to perform because her passion is still inside her heart. Her passion for music will never, you know, will never ever be gone, because that's the one thing that she really loves the most. But it's also one thing that destroyed her. Yeah, her passion for music. Somehow, yeah. I mean, showbiz and fame destroyed her. Well, just hope and readjustment. I think there are some changes in her career that's gonna come, and she's thinking about that. And there's harmony and integrity with the King of Shells. Energy and results, Eight of Acorns. I think she is really very energetic in being, being a superstar all by herself. I mean, she's still a superstar even though she's not touring anymore. Everyone loves her. Everyone is concerned about her and what she's doing. And I think she's still, you know, having that integrity in her mind. She still has the integrity, and she's not ruining her name anymore. She's not doing anything crazy like those times that she has a mental breakdown. you know, she cares because she has her own family, she has her kids, she's a mother, and she's putting a lot of energy to some results that she's thinking of. I think she has some personal goals and she's trying to attain them. Mm-hmm. And she's seeing the results of her hard work right now with the Eight of Acorns. Okay? Let's just say that she has a lot of goals that she already attained this time. Probably her physical goals, like, you know, to return to her, the old vital statistics of Britney Spears, because, you know, she was very, very fat when she became a mother of toddlers, and now she just, you know, she still has the goal to continue being fit. And that's really good because she inspires people. She inspires people to be very healthy. And I think she's also has her goals to get rid of her anxiety. And that's really good because if you're not seeking help from others, then you won't be able to help yourself. And if you will not let people help you, how can you be, you know, free from all those anxieties and depression? Right, so I think she has that goal in her mind, and probably she also has some goals with her career and how to continue making music and touring, you know, because everyone is very excited for her music. I love Britney so much. I miss her a lot. Right now, let me get my Other King Tarot. This will give us the present recent past of Britney Spears. Like, recent past is like happened 3 months ago or 6 months ago, maybe last year. Significant event that happened to her. And also, this will help us to know the future, near future, like 3 to 6 months from now. One more time. Universe, what do you have for Britney Spears? Okay, we got the Six of Cups. That's the recent past. The Hierophant in reverse. The High Priestess in reverse, Six of Swords. Mm-hmm. And what happened in the present? What's happening in the present? We got the Page of Swords in reverse, the Sun in reverse, Page of Wands, Queen of Swords. Okay, hold on. So I tried to readjust the camera. Sorry, I have to pause. So let me continue that for the near future. Okay, we got the Nine of Cups with the Nine of Pentacles in reverse. Oh, there's a lot. So let me just grab this too. There's Four of Wands and Page of Pentacles in reverse. There's a lot of reversals here that I can see. Mm-hmm. Okay, let me talk about the Six of Cups, the Hierophant in reverse, the Priestess, and the Six of Swords first. I think this is really something that happened in her family that really breaked her down, that made her kind of like lose her hope or lose her passion or lose her like she doesn't want to really care anymore in this. She totally feels so hopeless. There's a hopeless case that happened in her family. The Six of Cups is just related in the family, or her being a mother, or her being a daughter. And like she kind of really prayed, because the Hierophant and the High Priestess is like, you know, super similar to each other. She meditated, but she's not getting the result. That's why she tried to move forward, because Six of Swords in the tarot is like moving forward because you don't have any choice anymore. You know, try to go ahead and live, but you did not get the result that you really wanted. And there's something that really happened in her family with the Hierophant and the High Priestess in reverse. She lost her hope in this case. Okay, and she's just, it's a very depressing one, because the Hierophant and the High Priestess is together. They're both together here in the recent past, and probably this is related to her being a daughter. Yeah, I can sense that. The Six of Cups. Or some arguments, or some related health issues. That's very, very hopeless. Like, there's no any remedy. That's why she feels so hopeless and helpless here. Okay, the camera is moving. I have to adjust that again. I'm sorry about that, guys. Okay, there. I'm very sorry. I have to adjust that once again. So, that's what happened in here. And now let's take a look at the present situation. She got the Page of Swords and the Sun in reverse. I think this is a very bad news that's happened recently. Probably this related to coronavirus or something. A very, very bad news that she just received. And that made her very feeling down. Like, very unhappy about the bad news. Of course, nobody's gonna be happy if there's a bad news, but with the Page of Wands, I feel like the universe just let her, you know, gave her the space or reason to still believe, because the Page of Wands indicate new beginnings, and also it's a very strong energy, very adventurous energy, and I think she's kind of taking a risk. Because also with the Queen of Swords, it's about her independence. She is manifesting her independence, or demonstrating her autonomy in her life right now. And I think this goes along together. They get along together, the Page of Wands and the Queen of Swords. There's self-control. There's autonomy over her life that she's trying to bring in. And she's trying to fight for her life in this Page of Wands. She'd like to start a new beginning here. And a new beginning that she wants to... It's like freedom, you know, the freedom that I'm seeing with the Queen of Swords. Self-control and independence. Autonomy. Authority. And that's what she wants in her present situation. Okay. Let me just arrange... so messy there. And now let's talk about the Nine of Pentacles. Okay, and the Nine of Cups. This is kind of a very ironic, with Four of Wands in reverse, Nine of Pentacles in reverse, Nine of Cups and Four of Wands in reverse, and the Page of Pentacles. Okay, I can sense with the Nine of Pentacles, there was like financial problems that's gonna come in the near future with Britney. There's a financial situation that she's kind of like, she has to be very vigilant about, because there was some also an emptiness emotion that is possible to happen in the near future. And with the Four of Wands, I think this goes along with the Nine of Cups, Four of Wands in reverse. The Nine of Cups is about abundance. We all know that. This is a success card, possession, beautiful harvest, victory over difficulties, over difficult times. But there are some delays that will happen as well. I think she is waiting for the money to come, but there are some delays. There's some cancelled events with the Four of Wands in reverse and the Page of Pentacles in reverse, because the Page of Pentacles in reverse really warns her about being careful with money management. It is required. The universe is telling her to manage her financial matters wisely, like talk to a very good lawyer or financial advisor to give her the wisdom, the knowledge, and how to handle her finances. Because I think presently she really wants to control her finances, independence, and starting anew. She wants to start anew, but there are going to be a lot of cancellations here. And if she won't listen to the warnings of the universe, then she will end up really, really empty-handed. You know, there's a warning in the near future that she has to really adjust herself and to fight for her, you know, what she deserved, and not let everybody control her, even her needs or even what she what she thinks she deserves to get. Okay, well, she's gonna be looking for fairness here in her finances. I hope that Britney will watch this video, or her fans, because she is not doing any music anymore. There's no album, there's no tour, but The Zone is just recently opened. And I cannot visit that because I'm here in the Philippines. I live in the Philippines. It sucks. But I really want to visit that that place, because it's like a memorabilia of Britney Spears, or maybe an indication that she's going to retire or something. But I hope not, because she's too young to retire. I know that she's kind of tired about being famous and, you know, people controlling her life so much. And she wants to be free, because she's a Sagittarius, of course. But I hope that she will talk to wise men, you know, people that wouldn't use her, like people would wish her very well in the future when she become, like, when she reach senior citizen. You know, she'll be very happy and very you know, there's like a no regrets that she's doing. Like, she fought for her freedom, because we shouldn't be regretting fighting for our freedom. I mean, that's our birthright, and that's her birthright to be free. And I hope that she will manage her finances very well. Like I mentioned earlier, that she has to talk to lawyers. Oh, okay. One drunk card. Enjoy. And just Oracle cards. Tribulation. This is the ending of the session. Enhance. Okay, I think with enjoy, because there's nothing that she can do about these things, you know. She tried to fix this, but she's very hopeless, she's very helpless, and she tried to move forward with the Six of Swords because there's nothing that she can do anymore. So she just enjoyed her life, and that's why she got the Enjoy Oracle. And with the Tribulation, I really think that she has to fight over for her freedom this time in the present situation, because there's gonna be a lot of tribulation or adversity that's gonna come in the near future if she won't fight for what is right, or her birthright, her freedom to control her finances. Enhance. I think she has to enhance her knowledge in managing her finances, you know, saving for the next 20 years of her life. She's gonna live in the next 20 years. I mean, that's very good, very good. If she reached 75 years old, that's very good. But she has to think about now. She has to think about it right now. She has to make a decision in how to save her money, save her income in the next 20 years. She has to also think about her children, her sons, that she needs, or she has to also enhance her emotional stability, her mentality, her health mentality. Seek help from people and enhance her knowledge in how to really handle her finances. She needs that right now. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. I hope you liked it. I hope Britney, this video would reach Britney or her fans all around the world, because I'm one of the Britney fans. I love her. I support her. I always think about her because I always get the notification from IG and thinking how she goes. I mean, how, what she's doing in her life. I know she's inspiring people to stay healthy and, you know, to be clean. She's doing her part, and that's a very lovely gesture from Britney Spears. And that's all. And don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video. Bye bye.